dog park?
All right, 2 weeks to go in the NFL season. Gets things kicked off. Remember, I get all my stats and my numbers from Bet365. That's where I do all my online gambling. First, starting it off with the Thursday nighter. Houston, 3-point favorites on the road at Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay, the Bucs run D has been good lately, facing Deshaun Watson. He's got his full complement of weapons back, Fuller. Everybody's there, Hopkins. And Tampa Bay's without Mike Evans and Chris Godwin. So I don't know if they're as gunsling happy as Jameis Winston is on Tampa Bay. I just don't know that he has the weapons on offense to be able to keep up with Houston, especially with all the turnovers he gets. I originally had Tampa picked here, but I'm rolling with Houston and the number on this one. I think they can cover the small 3 points or at least be a push in this game, as I have this number at 3. Buffalo, big game. They have a chance to win out and win the division for the first time in like what feels like 50 fucking years with how long New England's dominated with Belichick and Brady. But Buffalo on the road, New England, 6.5-point home favorites, the Patriots are. The Bills are 3-1-1 against spread versus. The road team is 28-1 against the spread in this series. Bills, good pass D. It took a blocked punt returned for a touchdown for New England to beat Buffalo in Buffalo 16-10 last time. So this is definitely going to be a good close game in my opinion. First half of the season, Allen was a turnover machine at QB for the Bills. But lately, since about week 7 or so, I want to say, and maybe a bit later, but halfway through the season, he stopped turning the ball over and the Bills have been a much better team for it. And that's why they are where they are and about to be in the playoffs. So I like the Bills to actually win this game outright, so I obviously like them to cover the spread. LA Rams +6 at San Fran. The 49ers are six point home favorites in this one. The Rams are 2-6 against spread versus. San Fran, number one pass D, number two rush offense. The D for the 49ers is banged up though, and I think that's why they suffered a little setback recently. I think they will still win this game. The Rams just got embarrassed last week. I think they'll be able to keep this game close within the 6 points. Definitely San Fran to win, the Rams to cover the 6 points. Jacksonville Jaguars on the road in Atlanta. Atlanta is 7.5-point home favorites. They're 4-2 since their bye week. The Jags are 0-4 against the spread in this series. Atlanta's something like 1-11. I didn't write this down. I remember reading it though. They're like 1-11 versus the AFC, and Jacksonville hasn't won or covered in their last 6 versus the NFC or something ridiculous. They both suck against the opposite conference. Atlanta has at least been doing something. At least they have a few weapons. Jacksonville has more questions than they do answers for anything this year. Even though the records are very similar, or if not the same, I don't remember offhand. I will take Atlanta at home to cover the big number, 7.5 on that one. New Orleans Saints on the road, Tennessee Titans. Drew Brees, congratulations on setting the touchdown record. The best thing for me was that 29 of 30 pass completions, just absolutely fucking phenomenal. His completion percentage is top notch. Out of any passer, you can go back in history, look at anybody from Joe Montana, Dan Marino, Jim Kelly, Troy Aikman. Like, it doesn't matter who you look at. His completion percentage is up there with the best. I think he's one of the most accurate throwers. He is the most accurate thrower I have ever fucking seen play the game. The Saints on the road at Tennessee. They can clinch home field. They're 9-3 against the spread as road favorites since 2016. The Saints are... Playoffs, division hopes. That is the playoff hopes for the Tennessee Titans trying to catch Houston. And I think Tennessee has a lot more to play for than New Orleans, even though home field advantage through the playoffs is a big deal. Getting into the playoffs and possibly win your division right now is a bigger step for the Tennessee Titans. I think Derrick Henry and the guys will be able to go out and get it, even though Tennessee's red zone D, which kind of scares me a bit because they're ranked 30th in the red zone defense department. I am going to pick Tennessee to win and cover this spread, obviously, since they're underdogs. New York Giants in Washington. Washington is 2.5-point home favorites. The favorite is 4-1 against the spread in this series. The Giants are 9-4 against the spread in the last 13 in this divisional rivalry. Washington is 2-2 in their last four. They almost beat the Packers. They almost beat the Eagles. They have only one win in their last 10 home games. But I think Washington has shown me more the last 4 or 5 weeks of the season that I like where their young kids. They remember Washington is starting more rookies than any other NFL team in history has ever done. I think they're starting to find a little groove together, maybe have a little camaraderie in the dressing room or on the field starting to show. I'll take them to get their second home win in 11 games, it will be, by the time this one is done. And to cover that small spread as well. Pittsburgh on the road to face the New York Jets. Mike Tomlin said it last week, should be coach of the year in my mind. The shit he's had to deal with from the Le'Veon Bell, the Antonio Brown, both being gone within the last year. All the injuries, Roethlisberger out, so many people just, Connor, like the list goes on and on. And what he's done to get this team into the playoffs is phenomenal. And I hate the Pittsburgh Steelers. So that is big, big compliment from me to Mike Tomlin, in my opinion. Favorite is 4-1 against the spread in this series. They're out on the road to face the Jets. Pittsburgh's 3-point road favorites. Pittsburgh 4-1 against the spread first. 7-1 versus teams with losing records, as the New York Jets have a losing record. And here's the New York Jets offense compared to the Pittsburgh defense. Jets offense, total yards, 31st. Pitt defense, total yards, ranked 4th. Jets offense, passing yards, ranked 30th. Pitt defense, passing yards, ranked 5th. Jets offense, rushing yards, ranked 31st. Pitt defense, ranked 11th. Points scored, New York Jets offense, 28th. Pitt defense, 6th. I love Pittsburgh in this game. I think they get the win, cover the spread handily, and the Jets will be crawling home. And another fun stat for you, Sam Darnold, in his career, the Jets are 8-15-1 against the spread. So all signs to me point to Pittsburgh in this one. Cincinnati on the road at Miami. The Dolphins, 1-point home favorites. Joe Mixon, he is all the Bengals have, especially since Green is done for the year. I believe I read that is confirmed, but I'm not positive. Pretty sure that's what I saw, though. Miami, 31st ranked run D. But they are 7-3 against the spread in their last 10 games. And they are just playing fun football, loose, don't care, don't give a shit, trying any trick play and anything to win. I think they'll be able to beat Cincinnati in this one. And it's a 1-point spread, so obviously they just got a win to cover. Carolina on the road at Indy. Carolina 6.5-point road dogs. The road team is 4-0 against spread in the series. Rookie Will Greer looks to be the starting QB for Carolina. 30th ranked run D for Carolina, but Indy, I don't know what to think with how banged up most of the players are on that team. They definitely should win this game, but cover that number, I don't think so. I'll take Carolina on the spread to cover the 6.5, but Indy to win the game. Next, Baltimore. I'm not going to say a lot about this one. Ravens, just dominant team. Best team in football this year. Hands down, setting the record for most players going to the Pro Bowl. What was it, 12 selections or whatever? 11, 12 players going. They're on the road in Cleveland. Cleveland's beat them 2 of the last 3 times they met. The last time Baltimore lost this year was, what was it? I wrote it down. Week 4. And Cleveland was the team to beat them last. But Baltimore is 8-2-1 against the spread in this series. The road team's 14-5-1 in this series. I think Lamar Jackson, Ingram, Hollywood, they get it done. Baltimore rolls. They cruise by at least a pair of touchdowns in this one. I like Baltimore and the spread. Detroit on the road to face Denver. The Lions, they haven't scored 20 points in the last 4 games. They've only won and covered 1 in their last 10 games. Andrew Locke, he is 2-1 as a starter. 10th ranked scoring D, covered 7 of the last 10 games, have the Broncos. They are very good as heavy chalk. I will take Denver in the 6.5 points and for them to win and cover. Sorry, a little mixed up there. Oakland on the road at the Chargers. Chargers 6-point home favorites. Oakland 1-4 against spread in this series. The road team is 7-3 against the spread, though. The underdog is 16-5 against the spread in the last 21 against each other. Chargers were embarrassed at home by Minnesota last week. Rivers, Gordon, they're playing for new contracts, either with the Chargers, most likely with another team for both of them. But they have something to prove, especially after just getting hammered last week. So I will take the Chargers, and Oakland's been falling apart. They've been so beat up. Their injury list is long and long and long. They're going to Vegas. They choked in front of their home fans with their last home game last week. I will take the Chargers to win by a touchdown in this one. Game of the week, the biggest implications. The first game of the playoffs is this Sunday. Dallas at Philadelphia. The Cowboys are 3-point road favorites. Dallas is 4-0 against the spread in the last four in this series. The favorite is 7-1 against the spread in this divisional rivalry. Dallas is 6-1 against the spread in Philadelphia in their last seven meetings. The road team is 11-5 against the spread. Philly, the only thing they got going for them right now is number two rush defense versus Zeke Elliott. But do you really want to take that chance with how shitty the corners have been this year? It is just absolutely atrocious. Injuries have a lot to do with it, but you still got to play. That's why you have 53 men on your motherfucking roster, so you have players who can step up when those get injured. I understand the receivers even, but to me it's no excuse, especially with the way the guys you lost were playing for you anyways. At least fucking Ward, at least J-Jod, at least Goddard, Ertz. You can run Sanders, you can run Boston Scott out of the backfield. You can mix and match so many different fucking things. Wentz can have confidence. I don't know how this game is going to go. I wouldn't be surprised if this was a one-point game for either team. I wouldn't be surprised if Dallas or Philly won like 42-7. Nothing would surprise me in this series at all. It is typical Dallas to choke in these situations. I don't know. All the numbers point to me where I have to pick Dallas as the road favorite in this game. Or is it just me hoping to reverse a jinx and reverse jinx the Cowboys by picking them? Arizona on the road, 9.5-point favorites, to Seattle, who is 9.5-point favorites. Arizona is 4-0 against the spread in Seattle. The road team is 8-1-1 against the spread in this series. The underdog is 7-1-1 against the spread in this series. Arizona is 4-1-1 against spread versus 2-4. Seattle's 2-4 against the spread at home this year. Arizona is 4-1-1 against the spread overall on the road this year. So I will take Seattle to win this game, but Arizona definitely to cover. Seattle just don't seem to really pull away from many people. I think Arizona keeps this game close. Divisional matchup. Usually they are a little tighter. Once in a while you get a blowout, like how the Cowboys beat the Eagles earlier in the season, but not too often in divisional rivalries. So I'll take Arizona to cover, Seattle to win the game. Kansas City, 6-point road favorites in Chicago. And Kansas City, their defense has been playing better. Everybody's starting to get healthy. Worried a little bit about Mahomes' hand still, but not really. He seemed fine, so I think Kansas City rolls. I don't think the Bears will be able to do enough to stay close. And to rub it in, everybody remember that the Bears picked Mitchell Trubisky before Kansas City picked Patrick Mahomes. So add a little salt into the wound to the Bears there. Green Bay on the road, the Monday Nighter, 4.5-point underdogs to Minnesota. Green Bay has impressed me this year because it hasn't been your typical Aaron Rodgers gunslinger, just rely on Aaron to do it all for you or you're done for season. They've been running the game, they've been controlling the clock better, they've been grinding out wins. They haven't been really blowing anybody out. They haven't been pulling away from nobody, but they've been doing it enough to get it done in all facets of the game. You have two of the NFL's top red zone offenses and top red zone defenses. Now, this one's really, like, everything is telling me before I looked up my stats and numbers to pick Green Bay in this one. But then when I looked up the numbers, the home team is 6-1 against the spread in the series. Green Bay is 1-4 against the spread in Minnesota in the last five games. I don't know what to make of this. I'm going to have to pick Minnesota to win this game, Green Bay to cover. No, I'm going to switch it. I like Green Bay. I'm sticking with my gut. I like Green Bay to win this game. Obviously, cover the spread as underdogs in Minnesota. Green Bay will get a first-round bye in the playoffs. They're going to win out. I believe they play Detroit is it last week of the season, whatever it is, I'm going with Green Bay to win and cover this game. That's my week 16 picks. Peace.